All right, now in the next division, up to 65 kilograms, the very same rules, KW full contact. We're gonna see Chiara Guzzi from Italy. She's a Diamond League Super Fight winner from last year, and she fought in Thailand in the Taipei Stadium in 2019. So she's a good Muay Thai fighter. She is on the age of 23. She's 178 tall. And she will be fighting, like we said, just before Kim Alina, the student of the legendary Sam Greco from Australia. She has the age experience on her side. And she's the IKBF K1 Victoria title winner and the current WKBF K1 Australian champion. We're gonna see her in the ring walking after Chiara Guzzi from Italy. Chiara Guzzi is a bit taller than Ross.
Welcome, the fighter in the blue corner.
But we saw Ross on the scale and during the week training that she looks like really powerful, really lean. Kim Alina Ross from Australia, 36 years of age, 65 kilograms, 170 tall. She's the student of the legendary Sam Greco, who will walk her out to the ring right now. What are your expectations, Albert, for this fight?
Yeah, it is. I'm very curious because
Ross,
one is the boxer,
is also
and one is the Thai style. So,
36 years old, she's coming all the way from Australia.
Yeah, I don't
she's
know.
The holder of the IKBF
what do you see in a moment?
Victoria title.
I saw
and the WKBF K1 Australia.
The girl of Sam Greco, I saw a few fights of her and I saw her training. She was a strong girl, a good boxer.
We see the tail of the tape, like we said. 12 years experience more for Kim Alina Ross. She has a little bit of height disadvantage, both weighing in at 65 kilograms. This will be the second fight of the night here in the Ring of Senshi. Once again, Mr. Peter Arts will be the ref tonight. And we see Sam Greco in the ring, giving final instructions to his student. I'm sure this is really emotional for him during the week. I saw that he's a really emotional guy, like when the training when talking to people, he really gives it all. So I'm sure the support for Kim Alina Ross by him will be immense right here. So this type of rules at KW full contact, like we said, there are no elbows. So in this case, experience of Chiara Guzzi in Muay Thai would not help her much. She would not be able to use her elbows, but let's see what she can show us with her knees, with her kicks. You said that Kim Alina Ross is a better boxer?
Yeah, I saw some boxing fight of her. She's a strong girl. I think she's a little bit faster than her opponent.
Now we see a high kick attempt by Guzzi.
She has strong punches.
Both fighters in orthodox stance. Again, a high kick attempt by Guzzi. Inside low kick by Kim Alina. Oh, now a nice combo to the body and then to the head. Really good boxing combination with hooks.
Yeah, this is also in another fight, he make nice combinations. Turn the body.
We see that both fighters starting a little bit more calm and composed and more calculated in the first round, unlike the previous fight that we saw.
You see they have a bit more of experience than the other girls before you.
Now nice, again level change by Kim Alina. This time she went first to the head and then to the body.
Oh, it was a good push kick.
Good. We see them exchanging a bit of knees in the clinch. But it seems like that Kim Alina Ross prefers to play from distance so she can use her boxing more. Oh, nice jab.
I have to say, for girls, they stay both relaxed. Mm-hmm. And not normally the girls always give everything and they have more, they look more than as in the normal girl fighting.
No, it's nice left hook here by Kim Alina.
She's strong. I already saw her on the pad. She was strong. Yeah. She had good punches.
Definitely those punches hurt, but her opponent, Chiara Gusti, doesn't show any pain on her face. Now a nice block by Gusti. Again, some boxing exchange. Seems like Gusti seems, though, like a little bit of a bigger fighter here in the ring. A little bit more physical.
Yeah. But I think it's also because of this is a little bit slower. Mm-hmm.
And we are getting close to the end of round one. And we hear the bell. Good tactical exchanges so far. Both fighters will probably open up more in the second and the third round. We saw that the boxing combinations work really well for Kim Alina Rost, and Chiara Gusti prefers to play a bit more with her legs. Seems like in the midst of the chaos, Chiara Gusti is a bit more confident in the chaos. But when it comes to like crisp boxing combinations, Kim Alina is a bit more confident.
Yeah, I think she
that was a nice push kick.
More points. I thought, girl, I think, was the first one is always so.
Yeah. Let's see if in the round two they will be even more relaxed and more confident in their game. It's all set for round two.
Missed a lot of kicks. Every time she comes to court, too short with her kicks. And she has reached a finish, but.
Now Gusti start working more with the jab. Now was again a nice left hand and a right hand and a left hand again. The head of Gusti bounced back a little bit in those punches, but she's keep on walking forward. Stalking her opponent down. Now a nice counter to the body by Kim Alina. Seems like the combinations with three or four punches work really well with Kim Alina Rose.
But both girls are really relaxed.
We see now that a bit of feints by Kim Alina here. I noticed that during the Senshi seminars, you guys were talking about the importance of feints to make your opponent like freeze, to make him think and make him tired just because of too much feints. How important it is to use feints?
I think it's very important because when I feint you, you are busy with me.
Yeah.
So I think it's that you are already 2.4 and 2 points. If you are 2 points behind, if you are busy with me, and I'm also busy with you.
Yeah.
So it's difficult.
I don't think about attack. I only think about defense all the time.
So I can attack. So for me, it's plus plus. And she also get tired from the thing when she's come on.
Kim Alina trying to get in a perfect distance to punch. Now she lands a right hand to the body, but the left hand missed. Now again to the body and then to the head. Pretty technical. You can definitely tell she has solid boxing experience with her hands.
Yeah.
Oh, now a nice right hand by Kim Alina. she changes to southpaw now for a little bit. Nice counter kick. 10 seconds left of round two. This low kick miss and another low kick blocked. Now a mid kick to the body. Hard round to judge, but I think Kimalina was a bit more technical in this one, scored a bit more points. Just by pure precision shots, not so much from...
In my opinion also.
And she also made her opponent's head bounce back a little bit, you know, on a couple occasions. I don't know why Gusti is lifting her hands victoriously, but...
I think here in Thailand, they do it also.
Yeah.
This is a kind of copy, I think.
You lift your hands after every round?
Yeah, because I think she cannot be trusted in her skills now, till now. Yeah. But okay, you have to wait also the judge card after the third round.
You see that they're very disciplined in defense, very sound in defense. It's hard to find openings like in the first fight.
And normally the girls, they throw themselves open to give everything hard. They do both really good.
Yep. And I'm sure they punch heavier than some guys.
Yeah. And they don't give things away.
Yeah. All right, we're getting ready for the third round. It might not be the final round. Let's see what's going on now. We had two very close rounds. Nice shots to the body here by Kimalina. And a left hand to the face. Oh, now a nice jab. We see that Chiara Gusti is talking down her opponent. She wants to push the tempo here in round three.
But she's coming also.
But it seems like the more she's walking forward, the more she gets into the punches of Kimalina. That's what she wants. Oh, we see blood coming out of the nose of Gusti. Maybe a punch to the back of the head.
I think it was her hair she threw backwards.
Nice low kick here by Gusti. She tries to throw a nice jab again, but Kimalina ducks under it. Now both fighters know that they need to make the judges believe that they deserve the victory. So they're both pushing forward. It seems like Gusti is in a bit more control of the ring now.
Pushing a little bit more for one now, but she don't make clean points, I think.
Ooh, that was a nice spinning back fist attempt. Halfway through the third round. Nice low kick by Kimalina here. And again an inside low kick. She's moving a bit more, showing a bit more footwork, but she's getting really pressured by her opponent. Nice jab to the body.
She's still taking points.
Ah, classic combination, left hook and a low kick.
Looks like she's getting a little bit tired.
Now a nice block here by Gusti. She counters with a low kick of her own. Real close fight. Both ladies really giving their all here in the ring of Senshi, proving they deserve to be here in this elite fight night. Again, a low kick by Gusti here. Blocked by Gusti. Ooh, that was a good high kick attempt. I think it landed in the gloves though. Seems like in the third round, Gusti is a bit more thriving, a bit more confident, and push the pace a bit more. Hard to judge.
Yeah.
Maybe a fourth one in this one too, huh? I told you it's gonna be a long night.
Yeah, then it will be really long.
After the matchmaking is really good, really solid. Yeah. The guys are really like well matched. So
we have come to the judges' scorecards, and
we're all eager to see knockouts. But here in the Ring of Senshi, we don't have any easy fights. Let's see what will happen. Hard to judge this one because it seems like Kim Alina was a bit overwhelmed by the pressure of Chiara Gusti.
In the third round, I think the first two rounds were
for
Kim. But
both ladies lifting their hands victoriously. Ernesto had an easy job of refereeing so far, like they kept it clean both fights.
Yeah, both. Yeah. Only he got one extra round, so.
Yeah.
This take also long.
Yeah, most probably this one will go to fourth one. I'm sure that Sam Greco told her to keep it in mind that there might be a fourth one. Oh no, I think we have a decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a winner. By unanimous decision, the judges have scored the winner. In the blue corner, Kim Alina Ross
in
from Australia.
With unanimous decision with three judges in her favor, Kim Alina Ross wins her debut in the Ring of Senshi right here after three hard-fought rounds against Chiara Gusti from Italy. The fight was amazing here, the second fight of the fight card of Senshi 12.
Again,
the ladies gave their all and really performed. Really well, and I'm sure we're gonna see both of them in the Ring of Senshi and many more women fights here, because we see that the women do pretty well and they always put on a show. What do you think about those two fights, Albert?
Yeah, they were really good, and I'm happy also for Kim that she won the fight. She had a big flight behind the back because I think
from Australia, it's like 30 hours or something.
How many?
30, no?
Yeah, 30. I mean, so 30 hours that they lost. So
yeah, that's hard.
A long way to go. Yeah.
That's really hard for a competitor. Yeah, but she's now with a smile on her face. Yeah. You see Sam Greco smiling.
Can go happy at home.
Great performance by both ladies. Albert, thank you so much for commentating with me, man. I don't want to take any much of your time. It was a huge pleasure. I'm sure we're going to do it again.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
It was a pleasure for me to be here again with you, and I hope to do it for many times more.
Yes, for sure.
Every
for
time sure. I enjoy it.
Thank you, man.
So we see each other afterwards. And
yep.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys. Thank you. Now it's time for our third fight for the evening. Weight class 70.